A very big hello to my twin flame community and all of my twin flame friends. This is a twin flame teaching video again, and today I'm going to talk about the topic which is written below. Now, after the separation phase, you will go into the illumination phase, the harmonization phase, the surrender, the standstill, and then finally the law of detachment or the detachment phase, which will actually help you in manifesting your union, you know, in manifesting your union into the 5D reality first, into the energetic phase first, where the chakra merging happens, and then finally into the physical reality. So a lot of people have a lot of problems going into the harmonization phase, then the illumination, the surrender, the standstill, you know, as a whole, because the stages are not like separate from each other. They happen all at once. It's not in linear time, you know, so they will happen like one after the other or one on top of the other, you know, things like that. So harmonization, illumination, standstill, surrender is kind of clumped up into a bunch. Now, after this bunch happens, first of all, it is very difficult for people just to reach in this bunch, you know, to reach a harmonization, to reach an illumination, to reach a standstill, to reach a surrender. It is very difficult. But soon, because you will get so fed up with the separation phase, you will start letting go, you will start letting go, and you will start coming into the more of a surrender and standstill. Now, harmonization and illumination need a lot of research and learning about the journey. Illumination is illumination of the mind. Illumination of the mind can only happen when you know about the journey, when you research about the journey, when you have information and knowledge about the journey. Only then your mind can be lit so that you can light other people's mind, you know. If you don't research, don't read books, you know, don't read, don't watch videos about this, you're never going to reach the illumination phase, you know. The harmonization is more about integration with your masculine twin and reaching a balance, you know, a harmony between the male and female energies in your own body, and then harmony with the masculine twin, with the masculine and the feminine twin, reaching harmony with each other. And first of all, they have to reach harmony in their own bodies first, in their own bodies first. You know, so that is harmonization. Illumination, I've already told you. Then comes the biggest block which is going to lead you towards the manifestation of your union in the physical reality, which is the law of detachment or the detachment phase. Now, how can you practice going into the law of detachment, or how can you by practice make it your actual reality, you know? So what you can do is that maybe initially you had like 100 thoughts of him every day, you know. Now, when you reach this phase, you know, automatically, and most of the times these phases come in automatically, you cannot actively make them come. It is divine timing when you will reach which state, which stage of the twin journey, and you should not become too big for your boots that you should start getting ahead of yourself in the journey, you know, that you know that detachment is going to manifest my union, so let me start reading material on law of detachment and let me go into detachment. You cannot do that, you know, because the universe is more cleverer than you are, you know. It's not like you can trick it that, okay, I've skipped these stages and I'm directly going to go into the law of detachment so that I can get into my union. It doesn't work that way. So going into law of detachment, you can, I'm just giving you some signs where you can recognize if you are in the detachment state or not. And why I say detachment to the times 10, you have to repeat doing this detachment again and again and again till you can reach a bigger detachment, which is actually going to manifest your union. So how you can go into detachment, or how you can recognize if you are in detachment or not? Let's say initially you were thinking about him 100 times a day. Now you find yourself thinking about him 10 times a day, and even when the thought comes, you are like, meh, okay, you know. That's it, you know. You're not obsessing about him, you're not yearning about him, you're not actually feeling his lack. Your own life is abundant, you're enjoying your own life, you're doing whatever you're doing. Maybe you're just going to IHOP to get breakfast, but you're enjoying that, you know. It doesn't have to be big luxuries, you know, going on a cruise or going on a yacht, you know, private yacht. Those who can afford that can do that, but those who can't, it's not necessary for you to create big distractions. You can just create small distractions, but you will start feeling that you are very happy in those distractions. Reading a book, going to a coffee shop, meeting a new friend, you know, going out with your old friends, all this will become more important in your life now, you know. And you will trust, you will feel that even when you think about him, it's not in the same obsessive way, and the thoughts have lessened, the degree has lessened. Also, if you go to a mall and you find somebody who looks exactly like him, you don't go hoo-hoo-ah and call all of your friends, oh my god, you know, oh my god, I saw somebody who looks like my masculine twin, no, oh my god, I love Chipotle, you know, and he was there, and you won't do that, you know. You will just just notice it and you will be okay, you know. Okay, I mean, he looks like him, so what, you know, I'm fine. And then you will also come back to your regular sleep cycles, your regular eating patterns, and you will start eating healthy and other stuff. Because you, when you were in the obsessive stage, you know, your sleep, you were having sleepless nights and you were not eating properly, all those patterns will return back. Your biological clock will come back to the normal. You will not spend a lot of time on phone calls with your friends, telling them about what is going on or asking them what is going on in where they are on their twin journey. You know, you will stop doing all that shit. So that will tell you that you are nearing the law of detachment. And also, like I told you before, it will happen very subconsciously, very unconsciously, that you won't be able to actually consciously look at it in a way that you are reaching detachment, but you will be reaching detachment at some point on the twin journey. Also, you will become more loving, you know, even for the things that you hated in him. You will become more loving, you will become more neutral. His existence or his not existence in your life and also in the regular world doesn't matter to you. You know, he could be living in the same city, but for all you care, you know, that is the law of detachment. And once that happens over a period of weeks, days or months, every person's journey, they are going to reach union, you know, one way or the other. It has to be an energetic union first, so you will feel a lot of chakra merges happening in your body once you reach the law of detachment or the detachment state. And then eventually you are going to get into physical union if everything goes well and all the pieces fit together. Thank you so much.